Welcome to our Q&A. We've had so many questions and DMs in the past, and we thought, you know what, we should really try to answer as many as we can in this little video. So we took the top few questions, and we're going to try to answer those for you today. So yeah, follow along.
Enjoy.
Question is, do we have a TV? And the answer is no. Neither of us grew up with a TV, and so I guess we never even, that wasn't even in our thoughts when we got married. So looking back now, I do not know how we could have fit that in our schedule, you know, having
the
distraction
of
that going on, because I would just want to sit there and watch it. But we do have a computer where occasionally we'll let the kids watch some shows, whether it's nature shows or, you know, character building shows. But honestly, I guess the past year, we've noticed that the less screen time and the more limited screen time they have, the more creative they are playing together, playing outside. So we've really tried to actually limit as much as we can, because it really is an easy babysitter. It's easy just to turn on something and, you know, they'll be entertained by that. But I feel like they're actually a lot more creative without the screen time.
Yeah.
Two, do we have our goats, and do we have any future plans for animals? I'll let you answer that
one. Yeah, we still have all the goats. We got the two Billies, three nannies, and hopefully we'll have some new babies in the spring, summer, probably closer to summer.
Yeah.
But the newest thing that Carson and I have been working on is...
For months.
Chickens. We are actually planning on getting some egg layers, and I think we're going to start with the chicks and... go through the whole process just so the kids can kind of see that. And Carson and I have been brainstorming on what kind of a pen we're going to build, a coop we're going to build. And so, yeah, he's going to be the chicken man.
Number three, the first impressions that we had of each other.
Wow.
That's a big one.
That was my first impression.
Would that be close to like 11 years ago?
Yeah.
A while back.
No, I remember, the first two impressions I had, one was correct, one was wrong. she was beautiful.
Wrong.
And then the second one was that she was very quiet and introverted. And I found that later she was just acting shy. But normally she's very bubbly, outgoing, talkative. And so, which is great. I'm grateful for, because I'm, you know, the opposite of what she really is. And so I think we balance each other out.
Every time I was around her, my heart was just beating so fast. I could not think of anything I could say. I just sat there. It's my fault that you had the wrong conclusion. But it's something we laugh about now. The first time I saw Chad, he was playing ping pong with his little brother.
Yep.
And I just thought that was the sweetest thing. I mean, he was trying to cheer him on and encourage him. And I thought he was the best looking guy I'd ever seen in my whole life.
She hadn't seen a lot, that's why.
Oh, yeah, right. I just thought he was adorable. So that night, his family actually invited us over for dinner.
Which I requested. I asked my mom, said, Mom, can you please let this family come over?
That was so sweet. But no, I was just blown away. I was actually, I felt really, really hard that night. And I was just like, I don't want to leave. I love him. And I stalked him basically for the next few months, because he had a little blog that he'd have his little devotionals on, and I was mesmerized by him. And honestly, everything I thought about him then has just been multiplied by probably like 1,000 after being married to him. So I am very, very blessed.
She puts up with a lot, the good, the bad, the ugly.
We all know that's a joke. One word to describe each kid, and when we read that, we're just like, oh, it's gonna be really hard to describe each kid with one word.
Definitely,
because
there's
so much in their personality, so yeah. We're gonna try to do it in two words. I think that'll make it easier. Carson, our oldest little boy, is extremely creative. He could sit at the table for hours.
Very artistic.
Coloring, drawing, building. He loves doing crafts, and he's very creative. And then secondly, he's extremely sensitive. He's probably not your typical firstborn. He's very laid back, very easygoing.
Very discerning of people's, you know, what they're feeling and how things might make people feel. And, yeah.
I always say he's a clone of Chad. I say, Chad, he's just like you. So sweet. And then Brooklyn, we call her Brookie Lev.
Yeah, she's our social bug.
She is. She's just bubbly. Anywhere we go, people's like, we want to see Brookie, talk to Brookie. She's just so fun loving. The next is Everly, and she is the tender hearted one. So if anybody gets hurt or is crying, she's the first one to run up there. She usually starts crying
with
them.
Yeah, very merciful.
She's so sweet. And she's our cuddle bug.
Yeah.
She could sit and cuddle for hours and hours. So that's probably why she was in our bed for 3 years. We finally did get her out.
Wasn't quite that long.
Maybe 2.5. And then Holland, I say since the day she was born, she has done nothing but bring joy and life into our family.
She's special.
She's hilarious.
She is.
Really spunky, outgoing. She's constantly making us laugh.
Yes, she is. That's very true.
She's so funny. The next question is it hard to make it to every family event with so many siblings?
And so many siblings.
Yes, that was a big question. And I think it was easier when we had just a couple kids.
It was.
They weren't in school. It was
a lot more flexible.
Yeah, you know? We could make it to quite a few more events. But I think now that Carson and Brookie are in school, you know, that we try to prioritize our little family time and what we're doing and just try to make it as many family events as we can.
It's a hard call, but it's just kind of a balancing act. It's a juggling act. And
we love my family, but of course our family, we want to make that priority right now. But yeah, I hope that answers your question. Next, are you working on any more products for your store? And also a lot of people had the question of if the promised cards are going to come back in stock.
So with shortages and just trying to get a hold of paper and stuff like that, working with the printers, that's probably the longest, you know, thing that's taking the most time.
Yeah. So we will try to let everyone know when they're back in stock, but hopefully in the next few weeks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So this is the next product. I'll let you tell them a little bit about it.
These are the man cards. It's basically just a scripture card on a size of a business card. And it's just a cover. And it just has a quality and talks about different qualities that a man should have and we can work towards with kind of a synonym describing, you know, a man of boldness, you know, fearless, shameless, confident. And it has a, you know, correlating verse on the back just for memory or verse or two. And it's real easy to fit in your pocket. You know, it's laminated so it can...
Pretty durable
and you can carry with you. And just encourage you to memorize scripture. I mean, I know people have it on their phone all the time now, and but it's just something about reading it in, you know, a physical piece of paper and helps you memorize it, I think. Better for me, at least it does.
We're working on a leather case that's actually going to come with it.
Mm-hmm.
It'll
have a holder if you want to get it that way, but
So I'm very excited about that new product for guys and men. The next one is, do we have set responsibilities and duties in the home? And I guess, like, typically you would think of the wife as doing the laundry, the dishes, cooking, taking care of the kids, and the husband works outside and brings in the money and, you know, you naturally think of it that way. I think for us, it's been such a really sweet thing in marriage. Because I feel like when one spouse is overwhelmed or, you know, it's a heavier load, I feel like that's where the other spouse comes in and kind of balances that out.
Well, we're a team, I mean, and so a great, I guess, word for what we do is tag team. I mean, it's always like, you know, if she's overloaded with something, I help pick up the slack.
Which is often.
Vice versa.
He does a lot of laundry, a lot of dishes.
So, I mean, she goes and mows the yard. She loves to mow. And so I like, feel bad, you know, she's out there push mowing and in you know, 90-degree weather. And so I feel like this lazy bum, but she, you know, we love to do different things and be involved and know kind of what, you know, each other's up to, what we're busy with, what, you know, keeps us busy, and it helps us kind of understand the workload for, you know, both parties, but
Chad is very, very selfless, and he would never complain about anything.
True.
Like, basically, I'll give you an example. This past week, I have not cooked one meal.
She's a little sick with the baby, and
we're just overwhelmed, I guess. But, so he's made dinner every night, and so...
Which is not saying much, but...
It was amazing. So I think you just learn to balance each other out. And it really is such a sweet thing because I don't feel overwhelmed. He doesn't feel overwhelmed. And
it works well.
Yeah, we've done that our whole marriage. Which kind of leads up to the next question, which is probably the most asked question, which is, do we argue or fight? And I'm almost a little leery to answer this question just because people are going to be like, oh my goodness, that's not true. But let me preface it by, I feel like a lot of that has to do with personalities just in general. Typically when you have more laid back personalities, they're not going to argue really as much. I feel like, I don't know, we've really never had an argument.
We've never had an argument or a fight. Now, we have had differences in opinion. Yeah. There's been things
because
we don't see the same. Yeah, I mean, we're two different people, and that's probably a good thing. I wouldn't want to marry another one of me replicated. But I would definitely, you know, I think opposites usually attract, they say. And so, you know, I think that helps balance out a relationship, and that's been true in our marriage.
And Chad's honestly, he's a great communicator. So, I mean...
Oh, I have to work at it. You know, it's easy sometimes, like, because I'm more the introverted one, and I like to process things in my mind. And Erin, she likes to process things verbally out loud. And so there we balance each other out, and I have to work at expressing things verbally. And then she puts up with me internalizing things and thinking through things and say, honey, let me think this out. Let me just think of how what I'm actually feeling and try to express it in a good way or thinking about a certain situation. And so it's really been a wonderful thing. She's been very gracious. And I think when you have two people that are trying to, they realize that each other is not the enemy and that they're a team and they're working towards a common goal to unify your family and to, you know, help other people and try to live life to the best that they know how. I think you're on a good track for success.
Yeah. I think the fact that we both really try and strive to keep God the center of our marriage and everything plays a huge role in that.
Yeah.
I feel like, that's probably the biggest foundation by far. So I hope that answers most of your questions. We will try to do this in the future.
Yeah.